Good evening, I'm Amita Balachandra. This is Just the News. I'm standing in for Faye today. Let's get straight to it. Assam has tabled a new bill in the Legislative Assembly on Monday that bars sale and purchase of beef or beef products in areas, and I'm quoting the bill, predominantly inhabited by Hindu, Jain, Sikh and other non-beef eating communities or within a radius of 5 kilometers of any temple. Now, the bill also seeks to regulate the sale of cattle in recognized animal markets. These markets or committees would have to issue proof of sale and purchase of animals in a prescribed format of the purchase and maintain a proper record for inspection. Now, according to this bill, violations would lead to cancellation of the license of the animal market. Now, if passed, the Assam Cattle Preservation Act 1950 will then be repealed. Now, the opposition has said that it would push for amendments. Reacting to the bill, leader of the opposition, Debabrata Saika of Congress Party, has said that there are a lot of problematic areas in the bill and that they are getting it examined by legal experts. He also said, and I quote, for example, the 5 kilometer rule about beef, a stone can be laid and a temple can be built anywhere by anybody. So it becomes very ambiguous. This may lead to a lot of communal tension, end quote. Also in the news, fugitive jeweler Mehul Choksi was granted bail by a court in Dominica on medical grounds. Now, he was arrested and jailed in Dominica since the 23rd of May for illegal entry, alleging that his arrest was dictated by representatives of the Indian government. Choksi had filed a case in the High Court in Dominica seeking to quash the proceedings against him, and local media there had reported the same last week. Now, the case was reportedly filed against the Immigration Minister of the Caribbean nation, its police chief, and the investigating officer of the case. Now, Choksi is wanted in India in connection with the 13,500 crore rupee Punjab National Bank scam. On to some COVID news now. The government has expressed concerns of the gross violation of COVID norms and said that people are treating third wave warnings like a weather update. Now, Health Ministry also went on to say that 73.4% of new cases reported in July are from Kerala, Maharashtra, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh and Odisha. Central teams have also been sent to 11 states and union territories. Now, Prime Minister Narendra Modi will interact with chief ministers of Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka, Odisha, Maharashtra, Kerala on the 16th of July to discuss the COVID situation. India, in the meantime, has reported 31,443 new cases in the last 24 hours. Madhya Pradesh, in the meantime, has added 1,478 backlog deaths from the second wave of the pandemic till the 30th of June to its existing record, taking the overall COVID death toll to 10,506. Now, this comes after the government on the 26th of June issued a letter to all district authorities urging them to report any deaths till the 30th of June, which were not added so far on the government's Sarthak portal. In the meantime, Home Minister Amit Shah has said on Monday, and I quote, it was humanly not possible to control COVID second wave, end quote, while addressing a public gathering in Kalol Assembly constituency of Gandhinagar district. Now, he was speaking in Gujarati, and I'm quoting him, during Corona, the world, India and Gujarat have seen a very difficult time. We had to lose a lot of relatives. In the second wave, Corona spread so fast that humanly it was not possible to get control over it. But under that circumstance, Prime Minister of the country, Narendra Modi, attempted to make arrangements to provide tenfold oxygen to villages and cities in 6 to 7 days, end quote. Now, the World Health Organization has said that the Delta variant is ripping around the world at a scorching pace, driving a new spike in cases and deaths. Now, according to the WHO's chief, who said in a press conference, and I'm quoting him, Delta is now in more than 104 countries and we expect it soon to be dominant COVID strain circulating worldwide, end quote. Now, the WHO has also stressed that as countries lift public health and social measures, they must consider the impact on health workers and health systems as well. Also in the news, Serum Institute of India announced on Tuesday that it will begin production of the Russian-made COVID vaccine Sputnik V by September, with an annual production capacity of 300 million vaccine doses. Now, Russian Direct Investment Fund, which is Russia's sovereign wealth fund that markets the vaccine globally, said, and I quote, "As part of the technical transfer process, Serum Institute has already received cell and vector samples from the Gamaleya Center. With their import approved by the Drug Controller General of India, the cultivation process has begun. In the meantime, Dr. Reddy's Laboratories has assured to strengthen the commercial rollout of Sputnik V vaccines in the coming weeks." Now, Hyderabad-based Bharat Biotech, which manufactures Covaxin, has now said that it expects to get WHO approval at the earliest. In a statement, the company has said, and I quote, "All documents required for emergency use listing of Covaxin has been submitted to WHO as of July 9th. The review process has now commenced with the expectation that we will receive the emergency use listing from the WHO at the earliest," end quote. Now, a WHO pre-qualification, or EOL as it's called, is necessary for a vaccine company to supply vaccines for global facilities such as COVAX or international procurement. Also in the news, Manish Sisodia, Deputy Chief Minister of Delhi, has taken to Twitter on Monday saying that the capital is currently facing vaccine shortage. Now, he's written on Twitter, and I quote, "Vaccines have run out in Delhi yet again. The central government gives vaccines for a day or two. Then we have to keep the vaccine centers closed for several days," end quote. Not just Delhi, but Maharashtra's Health Minister Rajesh Tope has also told news agency PTI that the state has the capacity to vaccinate 1.5 million people daily. But as of now, only 2 lakh to 3 lakh people are being inoculated due to a shortage of stock. In Odisha, in the meantime, the drive was halted in 24 out of 30 districts, with State Health Secretary saying that the next consignment of Covishield vaccine was expected to arrive on the 15th of July. In the meantime, government data has also shown a drop in average daily inoculation since the 21st of June, when the drive was opened up to everybody above the age of 18. Now, this is the latest that's coming in, that the Uttarakhand government on Tuesday has now decided to cancel the annual Kanwar Yatra in view of the ongoing COVID pandemic. Uttarakhand Chief Minister has acknowledged that the cultural significance of Kanwar Yatra, but reiterated that his government's priority remains saving lives due to the pandemic. And this comes after the IMA on Tuesday requested the Uttarakhand Chief Minister to not allow Kanwar Yatra in order to control the eruption of a third wave of COVID, and that letter had also been sent. Now the government has cancelled Kanwar Yatra. Let's now take a look at what's making news in the world of business. According to official data, India's retail inflation has eased marginally to 6.26% in June from 6.3% in the previous month due to the moderation in rural inflation, even as it remained above the upper range of the Reserve Bank of India's 2-6% target for the second straight month. Now, retail inflation measured by the Consumer Price Inflation Index is the main price gauge that the RBI tracks. It remained high due to the increasing fuel prices and costlier items in the food basket. Let's now take a look at what's making headlines across the world. WHO Chief Scientist Soumya Swaminathan on Monday advised against the mixing and matching of vaccines and said that it was a dangerous trend. She said, and I quote, "We are in the data-free, evidence-free zone as far as mix and match is concerned." And at an online briefing, she went on to say, "It will be a chaotic situation in countries if citizens start deciding when and who will be taking a second, a third, and a fourth dose," end quote. According to Hindustan Times, she also went on to say, and I quote, "There are studies going on to mix and match, but we need to wait for that. Maybe it will be a good approach, but at the moment we only have data on the Oxford AstraZeneca vaccine followed by the Pfizer vaccine," end quote. Also in the news, according to official figures by the Mexican government, at least 68 human rights activists and 43 journalists have been killed since President Andrés Manuel López Obrador came to office in late 2018. Now, the reason behind these killings are allegedly due to drug cartels, corrupt officials, and business people who carried out the killings. This comes even after the Mexican government claims that it provides protection for over 1,478 people throughout the country. According to the government, the protection program is a guarantee of human rights protection organized by the Mexican state to safeguard the lives, integrity, freedom, and security of those who practice journalism, protect human rights, and freedom of expression. Moving on now, Cuba is witnessing its biggest anti-government protests as the country is battling one of its worst economic crises currently. On Sunday, there were reports that thousands had taken to streets to protest against the rising prices, lack of basic goods, and frequent blackouts. On the other hand, Cuban president blamed social media for spreading discontent that erupted over the weekend. Now, he tweeted that the Cuban government, and I'm quoting him, will not turn the other cheek for those who attack us online or in the real world. We will avoid revolutionary violence, but we will repress counter-revolutionary violence, end quote. Let's now take a look at what's making news in the world of sports. West Indies player Chris Gayle became the first cricketer in the world to score 14,000 runs in T20 cricket. Now, cricket fans have dubbed him as the Sachin Tendulkar of T20s. Now, this came after Chris Gayle achieved the landmark with a match-winning half century against Australia in the third T20. Now, West Indies beat Australia by 6 wickets and sealed the 5-match series. Also in the news, former cricketer Yashpal Sharma passed away on Tuesday at the age of 66 due to cardiac arrest. Now, he was a part of the 1983 World Cup winning team. In his international career, Yashpal Sharma has played 37 tests, scoring 1,606 runs and 42 ODIs, in which he made 883. Mr. Yashpal has also been a national selector and an umpire as well. Now, before we wrap things up, we're going to leave you with some good news. A 12-year-old girl, Shriyashuti Mishra from Tamil Nadu's Coimbatore, has bagged the second prize in the Sustainable Stories video competition organized by the United Nations University. Now, the video project, which was made by Shriya, explains a view on sustainability, and it will be displayed at the museum's Night Rest in 2021. There were over 400 entries from across 40 countries, and Shriya Mishra was the youngest participant. Congratulations to Shriya Mishra. Now, we're going to leave you with a quiz question as well. This is the question. A WHO chief scientist has now said that mixing and matching of vaccines is a dangerous trend. You will have to tell me who that scientist is in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching.